up YouTube, welcome back to my channel. This is Chet Talks, and today let's get straight to it, guys. Workflow. There are loads of tools out there that people are using to speed up their workflow, to make it more efficient. Whether or not you're editing on Adobe Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve or Final Cut or even Filmora or something like that, you'll find that there are small little adjustments that you can make to your workflow to speed it up. Now, if you're like me, you're going to be constantly using those keyboard shortcuts to help streamline and speed up that editing process, whether you're editing photos or videos. Those keyboard shortcuts are essential. I'm constantly there like Control B, Control K, Control, click. Now, the way I see it, the first step you want to take is upgrading your keyboard and mouse setup. Now, if you just take that one moment to step outside of the box and just think for a minute, what could be the best tool that I can use to help speed up my workflow? I arrived at gaming keyboards and gaming mice. Now, I know you're thinking I'm crazy, but trust me, guys, hold on a minute. Gaming keyboards and mice are brilliant in and of themselves. They're super fast, super quick, tactile. They're built to last. So when I thought about using gaming keyboards and mice, I thought, I'm not much of a PC gamer, I'm more of a console gamer. But no, I'm not using it for that. I'm using it for video editing. You see, gaming keyboards and mice have one very unique feature, and that is being able to program their buttons. Now, I know there are mice out there which you can do that, but gaming peripherals have really good softwares out there to help you customize each and every button. Take Razer, for example. Razer have their own macro or hypershift function, which allows you to customize every key on the keyboard when the hypershift button is pressed. And as far as their mice go, you can do the same. They have a hypershift button which allows you to launch programs from it, bind certain keyboard shortcuts to the button, anything you want to help you make that workflow faster. So there are a bunch of gaming peripherals out there that you can choose from. Of course, go for whichever one you feel most comfortable with and one that fits within your budget. But the ones I've gone for are made by Razer. And the reason why is because I use a lot of Razer products already. And I also now have the Razer Basilisk Mouse and the Razer Huntsman Tournament Edition. And of course, with the software integration, it will make my life a lot easier when I want to customize those buttons. Okay, enough of me waffling about what you can use, when you can use it, how you can use it. Let me show you what I've got. Check this beauty out. The Razer Huntsman 10 Keyless Tournament Edition keyboard. Now, bear in mind, this is a smaller form factor than your regular keyboard. The number keys aren't on there. It's small, it's portable. If I ever need to take the keyboard with me, it's great, fits in the backpack, no problem. Now, the reason why I'm loving this keyboard so much is because it's got the proper chunky keys. It hasn't got the small, flat keys which don't have a lot of travel. This got a lot of travel, a nice sort of clicky sound to it as well. I'm really enjoying the feel and the type of this keyboard, but as things stand, this for me is perfect. It's got a nice key construction, the keys feel good. I'm very comfortable with how this keyboard feels when I'm typing on it. What I want you guys to know is that if you are editing and you want to be able to visually recognize your keyboard shortcuts, you can pair a keyboard shortcut to a specific key and then give that very key its own color. So again, it's much quicker, a much faster way to recognize your keyboard shortcuts and to see them, especially if you're editing at the late hours of night.
Going back to talking about hypershift and using macros and things like where you can customize your key functions of pretty much every key on this keyboard, That is something which you can do in the Razer Synapse software. Now, I've customized some of these keys to do one function within my editing software, and you can have them set as profiles. So when you set up Adobe Premiere Pro, for example, you can have the keyboard function set up to that specific software. That is one of the beauties about having gaming keyboards as a standard editing keyboard. As far as RGB, Razer has it down. I think the software that they use is amazing if you're into that sort of thing. I mean, check this out. I mean, the colors. The colors! Now, enough about the keyboard. This is a great bit of kit and I would highly recommend it, but I want to tell you about the mouse. Check this out. Now, that is the Razer Basilisk. I mean, even the mouse. Check out the mouse. Look at that. That's got something like, what the hell? I mean, just listen. I had to go for the Mercury White because, you know, I'm a guy that likes themes, guys, you know? Color matching, color coordination is key. I'm a bit of a geek, not gonna lie. It's there, it's within, it comes out every now and then. That's me, people. The reason why I chose this is because, first of all, I don't care if it's wired or not wired. I'm sitting at my desk. It's all good. And to be honest, the faster response times, even better. But the reason why I chose this is, firstly, because it's got a really nice grip and feel to it, and it fits perfectly within my palm. That is a nice feeling mouse. It's got a nice thumb rest there as well. But the reason I also chose this is because it's got loads of extra keys or buttons on this that I can again customize. So when I'm sitting there on my editing software, I don't have to go to my keyboard, hit a shortcut to cut or split my video. I can just use this trigger, for example. If I want to use this as cut and this as paste, I can use that. So all of these functions here on the mouse, besides obviously the left click, are fully customizable. And this is again something which gaming mice have as a unique feature above all other standard mice. Also, not forgetting their amazing fast response times. I mean, they've thought about pretty much everything on this mouse. You can even customize the roll function. So certain small little things like this make all the difference. Razer make good mice right from the outset, so you won't be disappointed with this mouse. It's got loads of extra buttons on it and it's got a great sort of ergonomic feel to it. I love it. I've been using it for a while now, no wrist cramping or anything like that. But as an editor, I'm loving these extra buttons that you've got on the side and the control of the scroll wheel as well. Really, really useful when you're zooming in and out and things like that. I think this mouse in general has a great appeal because it's not that expensive. It's quite a cheap mouse. You can get lost trying to find the right mouse over and over again from loads of different manufacturers. And I believe that if you find something that just feels comfortable in your hand, that has the right amount of customizability, go for that one. Now, I know this is a video editing substitution for a keyboard and mouse setup. I know there are specialized video editing keyboards out there with specific shortcuts written into the keys already, but they're usually very expensive and very specialized to a specific software. So like I mentioned, these are tailored to using them with any software because they're fully customizable. You can have any setup you want. I've even changed the keys around a bit to make it more aesthetically pleasing to me anyway, but go for something which has the right amount of customizability for you so you can use it for video editing, photo editing, even music editing, anything like that. You're going to be quite pleasantly surprised with a gaming keyboard and mouse setup. And if you want to game on it, then hey ho, you have a dual purpose setup. You can use it for video editing and for gaming. Happy days.
Okay. So I'm going to show you exactly how you can set up a really simple hypershift function in the Razer Synapse software. And you can do this with any other software that you get on a gaming keyboard or a gaming mouse. But in my case, I'm using Razer's. So what we've got down here, just over here, we've got the Razer Central.
We want to click into that and launch Synapse. Now you can see all the other peripherals I've got set up here, but you want to launch Synapse. So we'll go straight into that, and that loads my full Razer screen. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the Razer Basilisks, and what we want to do just there is click into that, and that will then give me my full lineup of all the click options that these do. So at the moment I've selected this as volume up, this as volume down, this to show desktop, that to cycle my apps, and then these to scroll up and scroll down. But if I select this, go to standard, and you will select hypershift. Now you can see with hypershift I've got this set up to launch there, that to launch there, Photoshop to there. Now you can set up your profiles here. So this is just on my Razer Blade thing. So I want to go straight to here, and I've got my Filmora X video editing profile. If I click that, I can set my own hypershifts to those controls. So again, I've got my standard profile in Filmora editing, and you can see here, Control B, which is cut, Shift Control C, which is control correction. And then finally here, this is my speed. Now these are the three things that I use quite often when I'm editing. This is just a simple idea where you can even go back across here to your keyboard and set up a profile again. You can customize each one of these keys and choose what your standard or hypershift on each one of these keys does.
So ultimately guys, that's my advice to you if you are looking for a way to speed up your workflow when editing your photos or videos or any type of creative work that you're trying to do. I would recommend going for a set of gaming peripherals to help you customize certain keyboard or mouse functions into one click or one button. That's going to save you masses and masses of time when editing and just help you put those projects out that little bit faster. And trust me guys, if you're editing videos or pictures out there, you know just as well as I do that it is a long and lengthy process if you want to do it right. And if you can save time doing it wherever you can, then you're going to take that opportunity. So I would recommend these products hands down. If you want to purchase them, they're in the links below. They are affiliate links, so if you do buy, I will get a small commission out of it, but that helps the channel. And of course, if you're not a fan of Razer for any particular reason, or if this particular set isn't something that you would go for, then go on, go out there and check out whatever else is there and that's right for you, and see if that would help your workflow. Once again, I hope this video helped you guys out and gave you one little tip to help you in your journey to becoming a filmmaker or videographer or editor or whatever you want to call it. I hope it answered your question if you can actually use gaming keyboard and mice as a video editor. Yes is the answer. And of course, if you liked it, don't forget to hit that like button. Subscribe if that's something you want to do. If there's people out there that you know will like this video, don't forget to share it. Drop a comment below, say hello, and I will see you guys on the next one. Peace. Oh yeah. Ah, cold.